Okay, so the guy that you're looking at on the thumbnail, his name is Friedrich Nietzsche, and he often talked about eternal return or eternal recurrence, which is a philosophical concept which states that time repeats itself in an infinite loop and that exactly the same events will continue to occur in exactly the same way over and over again for eternity. Now, what I want to do here and what I'm going to do here is apply this particular philosophy to that of the law of assumption, for which I believe Neville Goddard simply made reference to it at some point as the wheel of recurrence. And what I want to point out here is that creation is so easy, sometimes we don't even have to try. It just pretty much does it on its own. Now, if you look back in your own life, I'm sure you can see several examples of this, and I'm going to give a couple here in just a moment. Now, I personally think the things that we really truly desire and really want and really cherish to have, I think those things duplicate themselves even more. So back in 2001, I really wanted a particular kind of car. I really loved the way that this car looked, and I really just wanted the car, like really badly. So much so that I was in a department store one day and saw a toy remote control car, which was the car that I really liked and wanted, which was a Dodge Intrepid. Growing up as a little kid, I had had remote control cars my entire childhood. I think that's just kind of part of a boy's boyhood. So like a little kid, I'm playing with this remote control car in my apartment, and I'm driving it all around the floor from room to room. And this was a really nice remote control car. It actually had little lights that actually worked, and the doors, front doors and back doors, actually opened, and there was interior to the car, and it was very realistic. So as it turns out, I wound up getting a Dodge Intrepid, which was green, in 2001, and I loved the car, had the car for about a year. However, it had a blown head gasket, which basically meant I would have to replace the motor, and I had to replace the car. And I actually replaced the car with another Intrepid, which was green, and it also had a blown head gasket. Within 1 year, I had the same car with the same problem. I didn't think much about it then, though. So in 2003, I received yet another Dodge Intrepid. It was a 2001 Dodge Intrepid. This car had been wrecked, but was being rebuilt. And I actually kind of ordered it from this used car dealership. And the guy made me a really great deal on the car. And I wound up having the car from 2003 all the way to 2015. When I tell you, I got the value out of this car at least twice, and I loved my car. I hated to see it die and me have to get another vehicle. Now, in each of these instances of having this car three times, I wasn't necessarily in the position to always choose a Dodge Intrepid. It would just so happen that they were always the most affordable, and it just happened to be the car that I really wanted and really liked. So I wasn't necessarily choosing them as much as they were kind of following me or falling into my lap. So as you guys probably already know, I filed bankruptcy in 2020. At that time, I owned a 2015 Chrysler 200. Now, since I'd filed bankruptcy pro se, I had to literally do motions to the court to declare the value of my car because in a Chapter 7 bankruptcy, you can only have so much personal value that you're not including in the bankruptcy itself. So I had to file motions and declare what the car was worth. The car had some damage. I'd been in a little fender bender, and it had a cracked windshield, so I had to take that into consideration in declaring the car's value. Now, I keep filing the motions, and I keep filing them in the wrong way, so the bankruptcy judge is rejecting them, but he would kind of give me hints on what I needed to do or what I needed to correct. However, he warned me that if I did not declare the vehicle the right way within a certain period of time, that he'd be forced to have the bankruptcy trustee seize my vehicle from me and sell it in lieu of the debt that I was putting into the bankruptcy, and I certainly did not want that to happen. Long story short, I finally got the declaration of the vehicle correct, but prior to that, I was so afraid that they were going to come and get my car that I got the title to my car and I made a copy of it. And I wrote on this colored copy of the title that this 2015 Chrysler 200 was my car and that it would always be my car and that I would always have it and that no one could ever take it away from me and that it was my vehicle, mine. So after my bankruptcy was discharged, I decided that I wanted to get another vehicle and I wanted to get a Dodge Charger. So this was during COVID. So car dealerships were desperate to sell cars and they would do it any way that they could. So I essentially traded my Chrysler 200 for a Dodge Charger. That was the car I wanted. Everything was worked out. The deal was worked out. They even told me, we're just going to come and pick up your car. We're going to pick up your trade and we're going to deliver you the Dodge Charger. As it turned out, that never happened. I never got the Charger because they couldn't honor the price that they had quoted me. They had actually come and picked up my 2015 Chrysler. However, we can't get the deal straight as far as what the monthly payment was going to be on this Dodge Charger, so I didn't want it. So of course, they send an Uber for me and I go to the dealership because they want to see me in person to get me to get this expensive car that I just didn't want. So at the dealership, we're getting nowhere, and I finally just say, okay, fine, just give me back my trade, and we'll just call this a wash. They inform me that they no longer have my trade, and that another company had come and picked it up, and that they were going to try their best to make the best deal for me with the Dodge Charger, which of course they never did. So since we couldn't come to an agreement, they told me, well, just go out on the lot and look and see if you can find something you want of equal value. Now, there wasn't a lot to choose from, but I did find one car that I liked that was fully loaded with leather seats, the big touchscreen. It has ventilated seats, heated seats, all the bells and whistles. The only thing that it's missing is a sunroof. So I told them, okay, I'll take this car. So we did the deal. I didn't have to pay anything in addition. So the funny thing is, it was the exact same car that I traded, except this one wasn't gray like my other Chrysler 200. It was a gunmetal gray that was fully loaded with the nice factory rims, everything. And it came with a 3-year warranty. This was the exact same car, same year, same color even. Gunmetal gray is like a very dark gray. The other car I had was kind of a light gray. So as I'm driving home, I'm thinking to myself, how did I go through this entire ordeal just to wind up with the exact same car? Then I remembered the colored copy of the title that I had done maybe 2 weeks prior. And I thought to myself, wow, I traded my car and wound up with the same car. Now, if that is not the wheel of recurrence, I don't know what is. And in this case, it's technically wheels because we're talking about cars. I want you guys to comment and tell me what you think about this. And if similar things have happened to you, I want to thank you guys for listening. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Also, thumbs up. And until next time, bye everybody.